In the previous videos, we saw how you could determine who has access to the transit service, and we calculated a measure of the quality of that service by calculating the frequency at which it was available. However, frequent nearby transit service isn't useful if that service doesn't take you to valuable destinations like your job, your school, the grocery store, the doctor's office, the airport, etc. To do that, we need to understand where the transit service goes. And if we can do that for an entire city, we can find out whether some areas have better access to important destinations than others, and we can use this information to understand other trends and to correct disparities. In the next set of videos, we're going to talk about how to model travel by public transit, and how to use that to calculate accessibility to destinations. We'll do a deep dive into the Network Analyst extension and important network dataset concepts, see how to create a network dataset that includes your public transit schedules, and use some advanced specialized tools for calculating accessibility. In this video, I'm going to give you an overview of the ArcGIS Network Analyst extension and talk briefly about what it means to do network analysis with public transit data. I'm going to talk about the service area, route, and OD cost matrix tools, and about network datasets, and I'll explain how network analysis with transit data is different than ordinary analysis when you're modeling driving or walking. This will be important foundational information for the later videos. We talked about the Network Analyst extension in an earlier video, but let me give you a recap. The ArcGIS Network Analyst extension is the part of the software that's for solving transportation analysis problems. It has tools for assessing the coverage of different facilities, for optimizing things like site location and fleets of vehicles, and for point-to-point routing, such as how do I get from point A to point B, what's the closest facility, and for solving origin-destination cost matrices. Network Analyst has several solvers, as we call them. The ones relevant to today's discussion are service area, route, and origin destination cost matrix. Recall from an earlier lecture that underlying all network analyst workflows is a network dataset. When you perform an analysis, you have to choose which network you want to use to perform the network analysis calculations. The network dataset includes street features and also attributes describing travel times and distances, restrictions for travel, etc. In our case, we're also going to include public transit stops, lines, and schedules in the network dataset so we can model travel by public transit. For most network analysis, you can purchase a network dataset, such as Esri's StreetMap Premium, you can make your own from Street Center Lines, or you can use a network analysis service, such as ArcGIS Online. However, for the analyses with public transit data that we're going to talk about in the next few videos, you'll have to make your own network dataset that combines your street data with your public transit data. StreetMap Premium and the ArcGIS Online services do not include any public transit data. So if you want to model travel by public transit, you have to create your own network. Don't worry, I'm going to walk you through how to do that in a later video. But for now, I want to talk about the relevant solvers and give you some understanding of why we're doing what we're doing. We talked about the service area solver earlier when we talked about how to calculate the coverage of your transit system, the area within a short walk of transit stops. The service area solver allows you to put in one or more facilities and one or more cutoff times or distances, and it will generate polygons representing the area reachable within that limit. But earlier when we talked about service area polygons, we were modeling people walking to and from public transit stops. The service area simply represented the area someone walking could reach within, say, a quarter mile of a bus stop. What if you wanted to model a traveler who could both walk and take public transit? You could create a service area representing the area reachable within, say, a 30-minute travel time that they could reach by any combination of walking or transit. This is different from before when we used the public transit stops as the service area facilities, the starting locations for the analysis. Now, we want to use the transit stops as part of the network itself. The service area facilities might be someone's home or their work location, and the transit stops are just something they use in order to get where they're going. The image here shows the difference. The smaller green service area shows the area reachable by walking from that location within 30 minutes, and the larger pink one shows the area reachable by walking in public transit within 30 minutes at 8 a.m. on a Wednesday. You can clearly see that the reachable area increases significantly when the traveler can take public transit. To do something like this, we need to include the public transit data in the network dataset, and I'll show you how to do that in one of the upcoming videos. The route solver is used for calculating a route from one location to another, Like, how do I get from point A to point B? The main reason I'm mentioning route is because it's easy to look at the output of a route and see what it means to travel by public transit and to understand the variability by time of day. Let's say a traveler is at home and they want to go to the grocery store. At some times of day, there's no transit service, and it takes 20 minutes just to walk there. That's represented here on the drawing on the left. So the traveler could just walk from their house through the streets and to the grocery store. At other times of day, there's a convenient bus service, and the traveler can take the bus, and the journey time is only 10 minutes. You can see in the drawing on the right how the path taken includes the public transit lines. So the traveler starts at their house, they walk to the transit stop, they get on the bus, and they travel, they get off at this stop, and then they walk the remaining distance to the grocery store. So there's two key takeaways from this. The first is that you can include public transit data in your network analysis, and that allows people to travel by public transit when it's convenient. And the second takeaway is that the optimal or fastest way to get from one place to another might be different depending on the time of day because of the transit schedule. Here's a graph I created that helps to illustrate this point further. The graph just shows the travel time between two specific locations calculated at every minute of the day. Throughout the early morning hours on the left, there's no transit service available. The travel time for this example is just under an hour, and the graph is just a flat line. That's because there's no transit service running at that time of day, so the only option is just to walk, and walking always takes the same amount of time regardless of when you leave. However, during the daytime, there is some public transit service available that the traveler can use at certain times of day. And at those times, if they time it right and they leave just when the bus comes, their journey drops to more like 30 minutes. But if they just miss their bus, then they're stuck. There's a long wait time until the next bus arrives. And at those times of day, it's actually faster to just walk to the destination rather than stand around waiting for the next available bus. And that's what causes these big spikes in the graph. For the route solver, we were talking about the travel time between one specific location and another. That's useful sometimes. But a lot of the time what we care about for public transit analysis is calculating the travel time between large sets of locations. For example, we might want to know how long it takes every person in the city to get from their home to their work by transit. Or we want to know how many jobs people living in each census block can reach within a reasonable commute time. Let's talk about the OD cost matrix solver, because that's the right tool for you to use for this sort of thing. Origin destination, or OD, cost matrix is used for finding travel time or distance between sets of origins and sets of destinations. This tool has the ability to use a time or a distance limit, and you can limit the number of destinations you want to find for each origin. OD cost matrix calculates the travel time using the network just like the route solver does, but it runs faster because it saves time by not storing the actual path taken. The output is mostly just a table of values with the origin ID, the destination ID, and the travel time between them. OD cost matrix can also be calculated for a specific time of day. As we saw with the example just a moment ago, the start time for the journey matters a lot. The travel time between each pair of points can vary considerably depending on the time of day used. I'm going to talk about a way to handle this issue in a later lecture when we talk about the calculate accessibility matrix tool. But before I do that, I need to show you how you can get your transit data into a network dataset so you can actually do these calculations. Stay tuned for the upcoming videos.